I always thought that Blackmagic Cloud was only useful for large teams and big companies. And it also always looked so complicated and, I don't know, unnecessary to me. They literally would have had to pay me to try it out. And, well, yeah, they did now actually. Blackmagic Design paid me to try out Blackmagic Cloud and to make this video, so this is a sponsored video, but I'm really glad they did. Not only because it allows me to buy food and beer again now, but also because I found out that 1. It's not that complicated, and 2. It's also useful for smaller teams, 2 people or solo filmmakers even. So let me explain how Blackmagic Cloud works, what you can do with it, and how I've been using it while traveling, and how it could be useful for you. Because I'm not saying that you have to use it. It's definitely not for everyone. Just want to show you the possibilities and how it works. Okay, here we go. Okay, so where do you create your free Blackmagic Cloud account? Because creating an account is free. Just go to the Blackmagic Design website, click on this little cloud icon here, and create your account. Fill in all your information, create an account, and then check your email to confirm your email address. And that's it, you're good to go. You can start exploring all the possibilities. But at some point, you'll get a message that you have to upgrade your plan. Because with a free account, you can only get invited to work on projects. So someone who's on a paid account can invite you with your free account to work on their projects. So if you want to create your own projects and project libraries, then you'll have to upgrade your plan. So let's take a look at all those plans. Click upgrade or go here to settings and then manage plan. And this is a summary of the free plan. You get 2 GB of storage, but with 0 project libraries. So you can't create projects yourself. But like I said, you can work together with project owners who invite you to work on their projects. Now, if you want to upgrade, there's a few options, depending on what you want, what you need. The cheapest option is to just add 1 project library to your free plan. That's $5 a month. And a project library is what you need to create projects. And very important, 1 project library allows you to create as many projects as you want in the cloud. That means that once you've created a project in the cloud, you or someone else can open that project anywhere in the world on any computer. But remember that when you create a project library in the cloud, it will only store project files there. So it will store everything you did in DaVinci Resolve, the project information, the color grades, the cuts, everything you see on your timeline. So all your editing basically, but not the media files. So how do you share or get your media files in the cloud then? Well, first of all, if 2 GB is enough for you, you can also upload the media files straight to Blackmagic Cloud. But what you can also do is decide to not upload your media files to the cloud and use an external hard drive, and then take that external hard drive physically from one computer to another. That's also a possibility. So it all depends on how you want to use Blackmagic Cloud. But the easiest and most commonly used option is, of course, to also upgrade your storage. And if you upgrade your storage, you automatically get a project library. So for example, if I upgrade here to 500 GB, see, I automatically get 1 project library. So I can take this one away, and then it's just $7.50 for 500 GB and 1 project library. And I've been using 500 GB, and well, yeah, for most small filmmakers, content creators, 500 GB is plenty. So that's all the plans in a nutshell. And so yeah, the basic idea is that you can store everything in the cloud and then work together with different people on the same project. Or if it's just you, you can access your projects on any computer anywhere in the world. You just need an internet connection. But then there's also cloud hardware. And this is where I always got confused, because I thought that you needed and a storage plan and cloud hardware to make it work. But no, that's not true. You definitely don't need the cloud hardware to make Blackmagic Cloud work. So the Blackmagic Cloud hardware devices are basically network storage solutions, like a NAS. And the basic idea then is that instead of locally on your computer, everything gets stored on a hardware device. And it will automatically create proxies and manage everything for you. And then, for example, you can work with a team on the same project straight from that hardware device on a local network using 10 gigabit Ethernet connections. Or use it in combination with Blackmagic Cloud, so that the media also gets synchronized to cloud devices in different locations globally. But as you can see, this makes everything a bit more complicated, and yeah, we're basically getting in large production company territory here. and you really don't need it to fully enjoy Blackmagic Cloud. But I will drop a video on the Cloud Store Mini in a few weeks. It's definitely also useful for smaller teams and solo filmmakers even. For example, you record a video and you do your first basic edit. And then once you're done, your editor, who maybe lives on the other side of the world, because it's all in the cloud, he takes over. And there's a chat function if you want to communicate. The timeline also locks when someone is editing so that, you know, you're not making edits while someone else is making edits. And well, yeah, then it gets super confusing, mistakes will be made, but it's all safe. And you don't need a lot to make this work. It's also not that expensive. You need one project library and enough cloud storage. But like I said, I think that for a lot of people, 500 gigabytes is plenty. But also, if you don't have an editor, if it's just you, Blackmagic Cloud could be useful because it allows you to access your project files on different computers, for example. Or maybe you're like me and you travel a lot. Let me show you how I used Blackmagic Cloud while I was traveling recently. So I had some projects that I started editing before I left and I wanted to finish them while traveling. So I got myself 500 gigabytes of cloud storage, which includes one project library. And that's all you need to make it work. Then the first thing you need to do in DaVinci Resolve is switch from local to cloud here, log in, and create your first project library. And here you can also choose where you want the files to be stored in the cloud. So the physical location of the cloud server. And ideally, of course, this is as close to where you live as possible. Or if you're working with an editor, somewhere in between of where you and your editor live. And if you're traveling, the best choice is to take a server that, you know, is close to where you're gonna travel. And then once I had my project library, I went to my local library. I copied the projects that I started and pasted them in the cloud. It's that simple. And then you get a few settings, of course. First of all, you can choose where you want the files to be stored locally, so the location from where they will be synced to the cloud. But then this one, the second one, is the important one. Do you want to sync proxies only or proxies and originals? And for all of you who don't know, proxies are basically smaller versions of the original files. So you can use them to edit faster, but they will obviously also download faster. But since I just wanted to finish editing my projects, I didn't want to export them while I was traveling. I just needed the proxy files. So I decided to go for proxies only. And then this, the remote camera access, is for when you're using a Blackmagic camera, for example. So you can import straight from that camera. And yeah, that's it. And then Resolve will start syncing the project file and the proxies in this case to the cloud. And then the next day we left, we took a plane to the Dominican Republic. And when we arrived, I took my laptop, opened DaVinci Resolve, logged into my cloud account. And within 5 minutes, Resolve had synced all the proxies and I could start editing where I had left off before I left. It really is that simple. And because I was only using proxies, the speed of my internet connection also didn't matter that much, you know? And here's an important tip for if you also want to use the proxies only setting. So in the Dominican Republic, when I opened the project on my laptop and it started syncing, it also asked me if I wanted to do proxies only or proxies and originals. At home, I went for proxies only, but in the Dominican Republic, I went for proxies and originals because when I'm editing, sometimes I add some images or some music. And of course, I wanted to sync that music or those images also to the cloud so that when I come back home and I want to export the project, I have those originals of the things I added in the Dominican Republic. Does that make sense? Yeah, right? But yeah, anyway, another advantage, for example, is that if my computer would have died in the Dominican Republic, I just had to buy a new one or use someone else's computer. Nothing would be lost. So you see, there's a lot of possibilities, a lot of use cases. It's not super difficult. It really is like almost plug and play. And that's it. That's Blackmagic Cloud in a nutshell. Let me know if this is something that you would use, or maybe you want to see some things, some features that they add. Just let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.